Hello, welcome to my vlog. I am here again. Today I am going to make a quick kimchi. I have a one bunch of napa cabbage. I am going to make a quick kimchi for my husband since it's been a while I haven't made kimchi. So I am going to show you what my quick kimchi is. I usually make a bunch when I make kimchi because it takes a long time, but this time I'm only gonna make a one bunch for my husband. Alright, welcome to my channel and thank you for supporting me as always, and let's start and I will show you how to make a quick kimchi. Very homemade and no secret recipe. Alright guys.
Okay, first I have this cabbage right here. I only have one bunch. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it. Let's see. I'm going to cut that. And this is not normally I make. I usually just cut it half and that's it. But this time I'm going to cut it small pieces. Okay? Cut it small pieces. Put a little water in there. I have water in here and I will put some salt. I will sprinkle that with salt. Soak that. Soak for maybe like at least 10 minutes for me because I'm just doing it for quick kimchi. But usually the my mother will make it is it takes them like 3 or 4 days or maybe overnight to soak the salt in order for the salt to soak in the cabbage. So I'm just gonna do it there for like at least 10 minutes. Okay, and while I'm doing soaking my cabbage with salt, I am processing my other ingredients.
This time I have the radish, the white radish, and they call it daikon in Korea. And I am just going to shred this. Okay, when it's done shredding, this is another ingredients. This is what it looks like. This is the radish. Okay. And we'll put that aside.
And this time I have some white onion. I'm just going to put it like that. This is the leftover of that radish. So I'm just cutting it. Small pieces. Because I'm going to blend this together to make it more sauce. I have garlic and onion and some leftover radish and some onion. Okay. This time I have all my garlic. I have all my garlic. I have my ginger and onion, and I will blend this up over here. And I have the chunk of radish. And I will blend this up over here. And all of that. And I have the rice bran vinegar. And I will put that maybe like two spoon. Just for liquid. And I have mushroom soy sauce. Just to make the blender going as a liquid. Okay, maybe like a couple of spoon. Okay, that's enough for now. And my secret recipe is I put some salted shrimp. And I will blend that over here together. Maybe a couple of spoons. Good enough. Okay, let's blend it up. And then let's plug it in. already chopped. And I have this bouilli. This is a glutinous rice. And I put some brown vinegar. Not brown vinegar. Brown sugar. And I mix that all together in here again to blend it up. And the glutinous, I just boiled water in it and put some glutinous rice and sugar. Now this time, I'm going to put maybe like 2 spoon for now for the pepper. This is, I'm going to make it as the sauce. And we'll put a little bit more later. Okay, let's blend it up. Alright, now the next step is I'm putting all of the one together, my radish and the one that I blended, all my garlic and onions and radish, the chunk of radish and my salted shrimp and some 2 spoon of hot pepper. I can, my eye is crying guys because of the onion. Alright, is it a little appetizing? No. And I am going to put some powdered beef stock. Now you don't have to, that's optional guys, optional. Okay, that's optional. You don't have to put anything, but that is optional. Okay, and I put another 2 scoop or maybe 3 of the pepper. Now you can estimate as you go along. Okay, you can estimate as you go along. So that's already mixed, you guys. I am crying right now. So this time, this been soaked. This egg, it's been soaked with the salt. It's like, I think 10 minutes. I think it turned out to 20 minutes. So I'm washing it again. I'm washing it again to get the salt in it. So it's normally, I make the kimchi and soak it for a day. But this time, we are only having a quick kimchi, even if it's not wilted, the lettuce. Okay? I'm washing it again. So drain this for now. Okay, this time I am going for my kimchi, my cabbage, to the sauce. Okay. Okay. And again, since we're doing it quickly. I am going to add another salted shrimp. Okay, you don't have to use salted shrimp, you can use fish sauce or whatever you want, fish sauce. And also I have another, maybe like this is going to be so spicy. And this is optional. The beef stock is optional, guys, since we are going to do this a quick kimchi homemade. I don't have to wait for another day to wilt the lettuce by the salt. Okay. All right. And let's just mix it up together. So my gloves, guys, is blue. I usually have a white one, but just using it blue. Ugh, I can smell the spiciness. Just mix it up all together. My eyes is crying, guys. Because of that ginger, the onion, the garlic. Really, my eyes is crying. Okay. Usually to make some kimchi, it takes about like 5 hours. Because you have to wait overnight to make the lettuce wilted from the salt, so the salt will soak to the cabbage. But this time we are going to be quickly pickle the cabbage. Alright, and you can taste it, see if the salt, it's salty enough. or season enough. Okay. I'm supposed to put some green onion, but I do not have a green onion. I have it in my backyard, but I didn't have thing to prepare. Alright, the saltiness is just right. The cabbage is not salty because it only take like 20 minutes to soak the salt. But the spiciness, the spicy is so, that's where my husband likes it. The spicy. It tastes good, guys. And we are going to put that in the pan. Alright guys, this is all done. I'm gonna put that here in a little pan. And we'll have kimchi. And this kimchi, guys, it will last for a week at least. It usually lasts, when you make a lot, and it lasts for a month. The better, the longer the better. But this time, I don't think this will last for a week. We're gonna eat it every day. You can add this, you can put this in your kimchi, I mean ramen noodles, or your some tofu soup. And there you go, voila. All done. There you go, guys. There is my homemade kimchi very quickly. All right, let's eat some kimchi. I hope you learned something. I know you already know how to make kimchi, because if you love kimchi and spiciness, then you can do it yourself. I am inspired by my mother-in-law. My mother-in-law taught me how to do it, but something that I want to make it shortcut, because I want to eat it quickly. I don't want to wait 5 hours or the next day. All right, thank you guys for watching. Thank you all very much for all my supporters, my invisible supporters, and my never-ending supporters, and you know who you are. And I wanna mention like a few names. Kuya Bin Kaibigan, Engineer Wally Blog, Studio Bats 92, Mayenda Arsenio, all the 4,000 blessings, and we have Team La Loves USA. Hooray! Thank you so much for your support. And Micah Jokes group. And yeah, that's it. Thank you all very much. Happy heart, people. Guys, this is how you eat sweet potato with kimchi. It balances out the spiciness and the sweetness and the saltiness of the kimchi. Sweet potato and kimchi go together, guys. Lunch time. Lunch time.